Okay, good morning, everyone. Such a pleasure being here with you. I just was taking my children to the preschool, and I wanted to tell them that I'm going to meet with people who are going to shape their future. But they are little children, and they would prefer to watch in Anna and Elsa and in Frozen. But nevertheless, I'm here, and I'm very happy to be here to meet with people who are going to shape the future of not only nations, but the rest of the world. Yesterday we had a very interesting dinner with some of the friends here, and I was telling the story of an AI Israeli company who enables to save life through scanning, x-ray examinations, and CT. And today I want to elaborate more in a short about an AI Israeli company that enables deaf people to have a phone calls without any intervention of human beings. It is amazing. The potential is huge. We have in Israel 2,300 AI-related companies, almost in any field that you might think about. And we are looking to expand what I call the AI gospel to the rest of the world, and Asia is one of the best places, especially Singapore, the best hub in the world to make business. And you're here, and it's great. After the collapse of the Soviet Union, the world was optimistic. For those who are much older, you can remember, and I was a teenager at that days, that the combination of the internet and of globalization created a very optimistic, I would say, sentiment. And in the last, I would say, 20 years or so, the world has become more pessimistic. We have to deal with many crises. I mean, 1997, here in Singapore, you remember it, I think, quite well. Then the dot-com crisis, later the 2008 until the 2015 crisis in Europe, the migration. And in the last generation, we are facing many troubles or many challenges that we could not even think about after the collapse of Soviet Union. I will give you a few examples. You remember well, COVID, pandemics, polarization, migration crisis, at least in the Western part of the world. And lately I was reading a lot about food shortage. Why I'm saying that? Because there are many tools that can fix the world, to make the world a better place. AI is one of them. Now, AI has what I call a dual use. One is positive, one is negative. And our job, our mission, I would say, is to use AI in the most positive way in order to change the world. And this is your job. Our job is to create the infrastructure that will enable you to work together. So let me wish you much success. Thank you, Noah, and the economic team of the Israeli Embassy. It's highly appreciated, and as I said yesterday, the embassy is at your service. Whatever you need, we do not control the world, but we will do everything human possible in order to assist you. Good luck, and thank you very much for giving me the privilege to be here. Thank you.